I'm here to review Payback 2015, which was Sunday on the WWE Network for just the very low price of $9.99. I wonder if Herman Cain has the WWE Network. That's a joke about Herman Cain when you ran for president, if you don't get that, because he ran on the 999 plan. Anyway, dumb political joke aside, Payback to me was not that great. Well, I mean, it wasn't horrible. I mean, it wasn't what I would call a horrible show. I mean, I did at least enjoy watching it, but it wasn't what I would call I wouldn't put it in the pantheon of great pay-per-views like Canadian Stampede of 97 or WrestleMania 3 or something like that. So, it was a good show, though, but just not good enough. The pre-show, both matches weren't all that special, you know, R-Truth and Stardust. I don't even know why R-Truth won that. And then you had the Mega Powers, or the Meta Powers, Macho Mandow and Axel Mania defeat, losing to the Ascension. Again, though, I don't get, you know, those two matches were just nothing special. So on to the main show, Sheamus and Dolph Ziggler, of course, opened the main show. Okay, match, two and a half stars. I like that they did the story continuity from last month, which Dolph made Sheamus do since he didn't do the thing last month because he backed out of it. Dolph somehow got busted open. I don't know if it was a blade job or the hard way, but Dolph got busted open, and then Sheamus hit the bro kick and won. I mean, I think Dolph and Sheamus have good chemistry, but I've seen this match enough, and I'm getting tired of seeing it. So the next match, New Day versus Kid and Cesaro, 2 out of 3 falls match for the WWE Tag Team Championship. 2 stars, I'm not going to have a star off for the finish, because while it's a traditional 2 out of 3 falls match, you know, with each team winning a fall, the finish doesn't make a lot of sense in context. Okay, because the finish comes when Xavier Woods switches with Kofi Kingston, rolls up Cesaro or Kid, and referee counts 3. Now a finish like that only works if they're twins or if they're both wearing masks where you can't see their faces or something like that. It does not work if Kofi Kingston and Xavier Woods, because they do look different. So I'm taking half a star off for that, so 2 stars. So then we get Ryback and Bray Wyatt. Okay, match for what it was, 1.5 stars. I know Ryback got injured in this match. He injured his ribs, and Wyatt went to the Sister Abigail into an exposed turnbuckle. So then we get the I Quit match for the United States Championship, John Cena versus Rusev. This is a good match. It was bordering on 3.5 stars. But the finish is a bit stupid. Aside from the rope thing, the main finish of Lana saying I quit for Rusev, that's not how an I quit match works, so it's kind of dumb. Because technically you're ending a feud on a thing that technically leaves open an opportunity for a rematch. And obviously this led to Rusev breaking up with Lana, which makes him dead now. Lana was the only thing that people cared about Rusev, and now she's gone from him, so no one's going to care about Rusev now. Which is what a lot of people thought was going to happen when they split them apart. So 3 stars, like I said, bordering on 3.5, but the finish was a bit stupid. So then we get the Divas tag match, Bella Twins versus Naomi and Tamina. 0.5 star, again with another weird finish, because this doesn't even end with a finishing move. Tamina nails Brie on the outside, and then Naomi slams Nikki off the top rope. I've never seen a match end that way at all. And kind of weird to see one end, and it was just weird. It was a weird, weird finish. So then it's Neville versus King Barrett. Very good match. 2.5 stars. It would have been 3 if they would have not done the count out, which was only so Neville could do the Red Arrow anyway, so why not you just, I don't know, do the actual not have a count out.
Hey, Ming, you want to help me go to bed, please? Okay, I'm going to go on in. You bring my stuff. I got my phone.
Don't do a count out thing. So then we get the main event, the Fatal 4-Way for the WWE Championship. Rollins, Orton, Ambrose, and Reigns. Otherwise known as the Shield versus Randy Orton. Because that's essentially what this was. And honestly, I give this match 2 stars. Because the first part of it with Kane and JJ security constantly interfering was kind of boring. Then you got the Shield triple powerbomb, which is a great little nostalgia kick. Then you had Reigns and Ambrose take out Rollins, and then they were going to fight. But I don't think they were taking it too seriously, in a way, if that makes any sense. At least with the way the match worked. So then Rollins and Orton recovered. Reigns and Ambrose ended up outside, and Rollins hits a pedigree to win the match. So I guess Rollins' new finisher is the pedigree now. Especially since he used it on Ambrose last night on Raw. Which I stopped reviewing Raw because Raw is hard enough for me to watch for 3 hours. It's hard enough to watch Raw 3 hours, so I've stopped reviewing Raw. I do watch it, I just don't review it because, So, again, Payback, not the greatest thing. I will say this, though. I do look forward to Elimination Chamber in a couple weeks. Not only do you have the IC Championship going to be defended in the Elimination Chamber, but you got the first ever Tag Team Championship Elimination Chamber, which should at least be interesting. And John Cena versus Kevin Owens. Now, that is an interesting match. Hopefully, the WWE does the right thing and have Kevin Owens win. Because in some people's mind, if Owens does not win that, there's going to be in the back of their mind that Owens' main roster run is over before it even gets started if he does not win that match. So, hopefully WWE does the right thing and have Kevin Owens win. If I watch Unstoppable, if I watch NXT TakeOver Unstoppable, I will review that. But that probably would not even be until whenever I want to watch it. Because honestly, as much as I like NXT, I can't get into it a lot because I think they only bottle storylines around the TakeOver shows. But I am somewhat interested in some of the stuff on Unstoppable. And I really just wish they dropped the TakeOver parts of these and just put the little subtitle of them. So that's my review of Payback 2015. If you like the video, like button is down there, subscribe button is down there, and thanks for watching. Bye.